evening, everybody. Welcome to the Tony Conigliaro Memorial Gymnasium for what amounts to season four for St. Mary's. They had the regular season. They won that. They had their cup tournament. They won that. They had their Spartan Classic. They won that. They're still undefeated in the state of Massachusetts. And they're taking on Chelsea tonight in a preliminary round Division III state tournament gets underway for St. Mary's. Chelsea's already played a game. They beat East Boston. Chelsea from the Greater Boston League. St. Mary's obviously from the Catholic Central League. Merriman looking for the tap. And St. Mary's will have it, and they can score first. David Brown is two. Henry Morocco is three. Allie Barry is four. One official called it a backcourt violation. The other one said no, it was tipped. Chelsea knocked it in the backcourt. Derek Kalangis is 20. And Omri Merriman is 35. St. Mary starts two seniors. Merriman missed. Baraka had two chances, couldn't get it to go. The second one, I think, slipped out of his hand. Slipping and falling. Merriman with the basketball. As I said, St. Mary starts. David Brown to the basket. They start three seniors. Chelsea is senior laden as they start five. So we played just about a minute. 2-0 St. Mary's, they go to that full court pressure. Half short, he got stuck. The underhand layup had no chance. Allie Barry for three. The other streak that St. Mary's on, they got their school record. Up and good by James Davis. David Brown again. Merriman took the ball away, but they're going to get Merriman for a foul. I hope you can hear me because the St. Mary's crowd is right in my ear and probably in yours. 7-2 St. Mary's, the winner of this, it could be familiarity with getting inside, scoring is Will Jean-Baptiste. And it's 7-4, around and out for Merriman. As I said, it could be familiarity. Austin Prep tonight is playing Norwell. Steps called as they try to get the shot off. They were on one side of the basket. They tried to spin to go to the other side because they were blocked. And now Chelsea coach Judah Jackson is screaming. They're getting at each other. David Brown goes over to help his father, and it's getting a little touchy very early. I'm not sure what the players are doing over there, even with David Brown being David's son. Seven to four. St. Mary. And they'll have the basketball. Knocked away from David Brown, but knocked out of bounds. And the Chelsea coach is still upset. He's parading up and down the sideline. They clear out for David Brown to bring it up. To the basket, it won't go, but he'll get two at the line. David Brown having a, it's his junior year, but it's been an unbelievable junior year. He had a tremendous football season. Co-MVP of the league, I believe. Now he goes into basketball. And David Brown and Allie Barry are co-MVPs of the Catholic Central League. Merriman and Maraca are all-stars. Tipped and knocked away. They give it to David Brown. Spins and lays it in. He's got 8 points. And it's 11-4. Blocking foul against Calangelo. Vasquez tried to go around him for the shot. They call Calangelo for the block. I think they said a little bit of a hip check. They got 11-6 on the board, but it's 11-4. That ball didn't go in. I guess they said that shot went in. Merriman strong to the basket, lays it in. Picked off by Merriman. Four in a row by the big guy. St. Mary's has opened up a 9-point lead, 15-6. And again, with the crowd, the place is jammed. With the crowd, with the music, I hope you can hear me. David Brown has outscored Chelsea by himself. He's got 8 points in the period. I didn't see that shot go in by Jean-Baptiste, but they gave him a basket and gave him the free throw. So it's 15-6. St. Mary's on top. As we mentioned, this is Division III preliminary game. The winner of this will move on to the Sweet 16. In a state tournament now that's being played all over the state. One Division III statewide. And the winner, I talked about the familiarity of St. Mary's. I didn't get to finish that sentence. St. Mary's, Austin Prep is playing Norwell as we speak. And if Austin Prep wins, they'll be back here and play St. Mary's for the third time, and St. Mary's has beat them handily twice. Keep one shot, no good. Calangis comes away with the rebound. Brown pushes it up. Allie Barry to the basket. The press is really bothering Chelsea right now. Almost a turnover, but they get it by picking up a foul. First foul on Allie Barry. St. Mary's got three team fouls, but they're spread out between three different players. Chelsea has one. They double up. And he tries to dribble around. He got the pass in. Partially blocked. And we got a foul at the other end. Calandra's looking for the rebound, got hit. He'll get two at the line. Big block inside by St. Mary's, either Morocco or Merriman. Chelsea moved the ball well. They looked like they had a good shot, but it just got blocked. Calandra's gets on the board. Galeano Flores is the first sub in the game. It's for Chelsea. As it's now 19-6, St. Mary's. David Brown picked it off. Calandra's out in front, lays it in. Four in a row by Calandra's. They were lucky to complete that pass. Another tough shot, picking it off and laying it in. Jean Baptiste. He's got six of their eight. David Brown comes up short. Merriman forces him to take a tough shot. David Brown. Spun away from the defense and left it short. Three-point basket. Joma Vasquez. Sacco and Dietria. Anthony Dietra and Nick Sackle coming in the ball game. Brown and Merriman go out. 2:42 left in the period, a big period for St. Mary's. 21 points with 2:42 left. They lead by 10, 21-11. Allie Barry gets a screen. Steps back, takes the three, short. Chelsea can get it under double digits. I thought they were going to call steps. Going to the basket. Chelsea's trying to do a lot of one-on-one. Allie Barry's going out. David Brown is back in. Almost picked off, Tietria knocked it out. St. Mary's is the number one seed in Division III. Chelsea is number 32. They're 11-10. St. Mary's with a school record, 23-1. Again, I thought they did call. They called an offensive foul. I thought they were going to call steps first. Then I thought they were going to give him the basket. And Coach Jackson on the sideline is beside himself. Morocco just saved it to Calandra's. Dietria runner is short. Tips it loose to the floor. David Brown falling down, got cut underneath. They cut his feet out from under. And he was going down, and he still had presence of mind to throw it up and try to get a three-point play. I mentioned Chelsea only had one foul. They now have five. And that's the third foul on James Davis. David Brown gets his ninth point. Makes them both. He's got 10. Top shot. Allie Berry gets it to David Brown. Calandrius couldn't hit it. Shackle, two or three attempts. Throwing the ball over his head for layups. He was under the basket trying to get the over the head shot. Chelsea finally knocked it out. Just over a minute left. Barry get hit on the fall away. He'll get a couple at the line. Off the rim, no good. Made one. And there he says their biggest lead of the game, of the period. Dietria picks it off. Calandrius had it stripped away. Barry had it stripped away. Chelsea finally winds up with it. Nice fake. Galeano Flores faked like he was going to take the shot. He let David Brown go by, who was trying to block the shot, and laid it in, and now Sacco gets called for a charge at the other end. 40 seconds, 39.9 to be exact. Tip. David Brown with a great play. He tipped it, knocked it down, and he got to it and banged it off Chelsea. Outstanding. That's an ESPN highlight. Merriman is back in. Calandrius goes out. Chelsea comes away with it. Merriman knocked it loose. Bonito was going to try and go by him and go to the basket. Dietrich is back in, and for the first time, Ryan Ferreira is in the game. Shot clock is off. St. Mary's leading by 11. Offensive foul. Merriman and Barry will be back in for the last shot. And we talked about Chelsea only had one foul. They're now over the limit. They missed the layup. Chelsea with a chance to get under double digits. The shot, no good. That'll do it for the period. So St. Mary's get out to a quick 5-0 lead, and it was downhill after that. They got the lead up to as many as 12. It's now at 11. St. Mary's 24. Chelsea 13 at the end of one. Chelsea will have the basketball. St. Mary's will have an 11-point lead in this Division III preliminary. David Brown with 10, Barry with 6. John Baptiste had 6 of the 13. Blocked by Barry, they're gonna call a foul on Barry. He looked at the official saying, I got all ball. The official said, no, you didn't. That's his second foul. And he's going to have to take a seat. He's got to wait till the first free throw. I don't know why they made that silly rule. Bonita gets the first point of the second period. This is that one, Merriman. I don't understand why the sub is coming in the game. The shooter's taking two from the free throw line. David Brown over the head, holding off the defense while he shoots it over his head. St. Mary's has matched their biggest lead of 12. The sub can't come in the game till after the first shot. Baptista with another basket. He's got eight. Maraca had it blocked and taken away. Blocked from behind by Maraca. That was a tough shot. They had bodies galore. David Brown too strong with that one. They stopped to take a three-point shot. Dietria stepped in front, picked it, but couldn't stay in bound. Kalangis is back. I'm not sure what that call was. There is no 5-second rule anymore. I don't know if he traveled, but they turned the ball over and St. Mary's has the basketball. I thought initially Chelsea called timeout because he was stuck. Maraca gets loose, it hung like it was gonna fall out and it fell back in. He's got his first basket. Another tough shot by Chelsea. They're trying to do an awful lot one-on-one. David Brown for three. The lead jumps to 15. A 7-3 lead run by the Spartans. In the first, just about 2 minutes of the second period. The gym is packed. There's not much room in this gym anyway, but now it's even more packed. Behind me, St. Mary's rooting, the students, their section is full and they're standing out. They're almost out on the court. The press is really bothering Chelsea. And they're taking some really tough shots. They try to do a lot by themselves. Picked off by Merriman. Back and forth, Merriman to Kalangis, who finally lays it in. I'll take it, you take it. No, you take it. They finally lay it in. Swatted away by Dietrich, and he saved it. What a great play. David Brown slams it.
Yeah.
Blocked by Dietria. Merriman slams it. And the student body goes wild. Ending that long run is Bonita. David Brown! A 13-3 run, build that lead up to 21, and now David Brown follows the basket by Benito with a three, and St. Mary's coasting at 40-18. And Benito will get he makes the first, he'll get the bonus. Yeah, we got a foul. That's going to put David Brown at the foul line. He's already got 20. In and out. Sacco almost got it back. David Brown doesn't miss that free throw very often. He had to hurry that shot. Nassim Clearpath in the game. Dietria for three off the rim, no good. Clearpath had the rebound, got taken away, now he steals it away. Up and good by Merriman. Clearpath making his presence felt as soon as he gets on the floor. And here he's back with that 22-point lead. We got a timeout. Called by Chelsea coach Judah Jackson. 3:35 left in a mammoth first half for St. Mary's, and a mammoth first half by David Brown. He's got 20. He's matched the 20 that Chelsea has put up. He's got 20 of the 42 that St. Mary's has put up. And St. Mary's well on their way to victory number 24 and moving one step closer to that other notch they want to get in their belt, the state championship. We mentioned Austin Prep from the Catholic Central League is playing Norwell right now. The winner of that will be here, this being Friday night, I would guess maybe Tuesday of next week. Maybe Monday. This is a big night for St. Mary's. The girls, I hear it's a rare doubleheader, boys and girls. Usually one's home, one's away. Except during the Spartan Classic. And I think even that was, the boys played Monday, the girls played Tuesday. So it's a rare doubleheader night here at the Conigliaro Gymnasium. Double up, they take it away, it goes to the floor. Sackle saves it to Dietria, St. Mary's takes it away again. In and out. They saved it. Merriman was coming the pass a little bit behind him. He couldn't get a grip on it. He tipped it. The ball goes to the floor. The tie-up will give the ball to St. Mary's. Ryan Freer back in the game. Merriman off the rim. Sacco battling. Chelsea comes away with it. And Ryan Freer's going to commit the foul, and that'll put Chelsea at the line for 1-on-1. Morocco is coming back for St. Mary's. And James Davis comes back for Chelsea. Davis is out there with three fouls. Surprising they'll bring him back with 3 minutes left with three fouls. Shot is good. Jaden Baptista gets on the board. Makes them both. They give it to David Brown to bring up. Chelsea looking to double up. Brian Freer thought Chelsea touched it, but they didn't. David Brown not happy. He thought there was a foul before that. David Brown got his 300th win this season. Does a tremendous job. Off the rim, no good. David Brown high in the air for the rebound. Kicks it out to the corner. Morocco got knocked down as he made the three. They missed him last year. You see that, if you can see the brace on his right leg. He sat out the biggest part of last year. Couldn't play with that leg. He's been back this year and he's been playing great. Looking for a 4-point play. And he gets it. He's got six in the period. And St. Mary's has doubled up, plus two, 46 to 22. Morocco strips it away, and they're going to get, I think, going to get Morocco for a foul, for a grab. And now we got a little extracurricular activity. Vasquez didn't like the ball being taken away.
You don't want it. You don't want it. You.
They called a foul on Chelsea. I thought they were calling it on Morocco. Morocco's going to get two at the line. He makes the first. He's got seven all in this period. In and out. They lost it out of bounds. Again, Chelsea trying to do an awful lot one-on-one, taking some tough shots. Looking to go to the basket, and they know they're getting doubled. Allie Barry is back in. St. Mary's has scored 100 points in two games this year. And they're on the verge of having 50 here in the first. Barry, I think he felt the contact, threw it up. And that's the third foul on Bautista. So they got two guys out there with three fouls. I don't know if they're going to give him, if they call it a shooting foul, they'll give him three. He was outside the arc. Makes the first. Makes them both. He's got eight. Almost lost it. David Brown forced him to alter the shot. It looked like he was going to get an easy shot. David Brown went up in the air and he had to throw it over David Brown and wound up throwing an air ball. Shot is shot. Tiberius with that double in the backcourt. Now they double in the front court. When you think you got them beat, I beat my man, I can go to the basket. They're doubling up and tripling up. And they're really forcing Chelsea to play. I think Chelsea would rather play a slow tempo set up, look for a shot, and they can't because St. Mary's is forcing them to speed it up. Seven points in the period by Benito. Allie Barry makes the basket and gets fouled. And St. Mary's has gone over 50 in the first half. They lead by 27. Barry looking for a three-point play. He's got 10. Herman and Morocco have combined for 15. Barry goes out with those two fouls. They're alternating Barry, offense and defense. He comes in for offense, goes back out. Three-point bomb by Benito. He's got 10 all in this period. Chelsea with a takeaway. Shot no good. David Brown gets run over. He'll get two at the line. They just run. They double team defensively. They move the ball around. They force you to do everything a lot quicker than you'd like. And it's worked very well for him so far. A rare second miss by David Brown. Three-point basket by Vasquez, his second. Shot clock is off. David Brown found the bottom of the rim. Dietrich at the buzzer, off the rim and out. So St. Mary scored the first five of the game. They built up a 24-13 lead at the end of one. They went on a 16-5 run in the second period to get the lead up to 22, and it just kept multiplying from there. It ends at 23 at St. Mary's 53, Chelsea 30 at halftime. Welcome back to the Conigliaro Memorial Gymnasium as we start the second half. A big first half of St. Mary's, 53-30. Chelsea have the basketball, and with only 30 points in the first half, they have to get almost that many if St. Mary's doesn't score a point to get back in this one. St. Mary's right away picks off the pass. The flip to Merriman from Brown. He stuffs it home. Another three-point basket by Vasquez. That's his third. They lob it up for David Brown. They love that play. They run it quite often for Brown. They run it for Merriman. They try to run it a few times for Barry. But David Brown, for his size, he gets up and slams it home, and the student body goes wild. Another tough shot, partially blocked by Brown. They run it again. Merriman, three straight flushes to start the third period. They love that play. Chelsea gets loose and gets a rare basket. David Brown gets fouled. Sean Baptiste got that basket. He's got 10. Bonita got 10 all in the second period. For St. Mary's, Brown had 20. Maraca had 7. Calanzas had 6. Merriman had 8. And Barry had 11. And now Merriman has 12 with the two baskets here as Brown gets his third point. He's got 24. So St. Mary's well on their way to the Sweet 16. Merriman commits the foul. Are they going to give him the basket? The basket's good. So Davis gets the basket, looking for a three-point play. And he gets it. There you go, full court pressure. They get into Maraca. Herman with the wraparound couldn't get it to go. Strong to the basket, Vasquez. He's got 5 in the period. Calanzas, great pass. Nice look by David Brown with his head up. hit Kalinges in stride for the easy layup. Partially blocked, saved, the shot clock runs out. Off the rim, no good, tip to Merriman. Kind of a wild shot by Merriman, the underhand scoop. It goes to the floor, Chelsea comes away with it. Shot, 3-point basket by Baptista. For another three. He's got three of them. He's got 28 points. Long 3-point bomb. Halle Berry bounced all around the rim, didn't go, it fell out. Barry looked for one out of two. Chelsea's now have three players out there with three fouls. Barry makes the free throw. Just past the halfway mark of this third period, all St. Mary's. And they still have that full court press on. Tip almost stolen away. Now they lose it out of bounds. They're forcing it at up tempo. They don't want to play that quick. Off the rim, no good. Stripped away by Brown. Chelsea gets it back. Wide open inside. They missed the layup. Blocked by Maraca, and a tip from Kalinges to Maraca. Merriman's gonna get called for the foul. Kind of a slow period. They've got 14, but they got 24 in the first, 29 in the second. Shot partially blocked, Kalinges with the rebound. David Brown. He's got 30. In and out, Brown with the rebound. They get the pass to Barry, break it down the lane, he got hit. Bodies go down. Baptista picked up his fourth foul. David Brown again, another three. He's got four of them. Partially blocked. The rebound. Missed the layup, but he got fouled, missing it. Mary's leading up by 29, 72 to 43. Calandra's picked up his third foul. 1:22 left in this third period. St. Mary's is going to move on. They could possibly play Catholic Central League, Austin Prep. If Austin Prep could beat Norwell, they're playing right now at Norwell. They missed them both. Petria, too strong. Barry got the rebound and laid it in. He gives a little flex. He went up, just tipped it away from the defense, picked it off, laid it in and got hit. And he's looking for a three-point play. And St. Mary's has built the lead up to 31. Missed the free throw. Barry is closing in on 1,000 points. He needed 68 coming into tonight. Tough shot. Rebound goes to Sacco. Allie Barry. Allie Barry. He's got 20. St. Mary's with 80 points with a period left. Shot clock is off. Barry with back-to-back threes. And as you can tell, Chelsea throws the ball away. St. Mary's can take the last shot if they choose. The student body going crazy behind me, as you can probably tell. David Brown taking his time. We got an offensive foul, I think. Oh no, I thought they were gonna call a foul on Calandra's. They called it on Chelsea, knocking Calandra's down. I'm not sure why he's getting free throws. He was lining up like he was gonna take foul shots. They blocked it from behind. And that's gonna do it for the period, although they get one more. They get Galeano Flores got open for the layup. So St. Mary's puts up 27 on the board. With 8 minutes left, St. Mary's comfortably ahead, 80 to 45, ready to move on to the Sweet 16. St. Mary's with the basketball. leading by 35. They tried that lob to Merriman. Chelsea was ready for that one that time. Shot partially blocked. They try to go deep to Ali Barry. Picked off by Jean-Baptiste, but it went out of bounds off Chelsea. So the Greater Boston League is going to go down to the Catholic Central League. Shot no good. Dietria strong to the basket. Around the rim and out, and Sacco and Dietria combined to knock it out of bounds. They double up, he stepped into the backcourt. David Brown. Talk about having a night. Chelsea has 45, David Brown has 35. Stripped away by Morocco, but it goes out of bounds. We mentioned Chelsea was 11-10 coming in. They're gonna finish up at 500. Almost stolen away by Barry. Sacco gets a piece of Benito. That's the first point since the second period. You get 10 points in the second period. That's his 11th point. They've got three guys in double figures, but it doesn't offset. Ali Barry shot, hit the guide wire, hit the rim, bounced up and hit the guide wire up over the basket. Those three in double figures can't offset the 35 by David Brown and the 20 by Ali Barry. And that doesn't count Merriman's 12, or Calange's 8, or Morocco's 7. Shot clock went off. David Brown with 35. We saw Barry get 40. A game or two ago. Wrap around goes for Benito. He's played well for them. Off the rim, no good. Morocco's gonna pick up the foul. St. Mary's needs 15 points to get their third 100-point game of the season. three-point basket by Vasquez. He's got four of them. Barry gets the basket. Looking for a three-point play. I mentioned David Brown having a great year with football and basketball. Allie Berry as well. St. Mary's is one game away from going to the Super Bowl. And if Kalangis was not hurt, they might have won the game and gone to the Super Bowl. Barry was the quarterback, had a great year. He's got 23. Stolen away by David Brown. Gets hit, he'll go to the free throw line. With a chance to put 40 on the board, he's got 38. Both teams will be shooting free throws, and we're not quite at the halfway mark of this fourth period. Down and out. Missed them both. Very unusual. Off St. Mary's. Partially blocked by Merriman. Barry for three. Around the rim and out. Follow by David Brown. He gets his 40. Martin Marenzi and Ryan Frey getting set to come in. With a half a period left, St. Mary's has 90 points on the board. David Brown has 40. And Benito back at the line. Eight of his 15 have come from the free throw line. Missed it. Partially blocked. Ryan Freya. Allie Barry looking to go to the basket. Off the rim, no good. Off the rim again, no good. Touchdown pass to Galeano Flores. Merriman in and out. Air ball picked off for foul against Merriman. Chelsea's getting a run a little bit. St. Mary's is just looking for rebounds, looking for plays, and rebound by Chelsea. They can throw those touchdown passes because there's nobody back on defense for St. Mary's. Leading by 35. Off the rim, no good. Kyle Rush, and I think it's Donovan Clark is the other one coming in. And they'll go deep to their bench. Missed the shot. Just under 3 minutes left. Marenzi to the basket. Can you tell he's a favorite with the student body? 3-point basket by Benito. They were rooting for him to get in the game. They were surely rooting for him to score. Ryan Freer is going to go to the free throw line and get 1-on-1. The game hasn't been in doubt since midway through the first period. It's been all St. Mary's. The only question now, will they get the 8 points to get to 100 for the third time? Ryan Freer, an excellent three-sport athlete. Helped St. Mary's win a state championship. That sub was not Donovan, that was Josiah Quintana who goes out. And Maddox Romero comes in for St. Mary's. He helped St. Mary's win a baseball state championship last year. Very good soccer player and obviously basketball. So a very good three-sport athlete. He makes them both. He'll go out. And Aleph Potter in the game is David Brown getting everybody some playing time. Fall away, no good. Marenzi with the rebound. Short is short. Off the rim, no good. Had the three, didn't take it. Those are the kind of coaches. It was a block, no, it was a charge, no, it was a block. They call it on Romero. Missed the first. He's probably too close. He's made 4 3-point baskets. Missed it. Quintana with the rebound. In and out by Marenzi. Stolen away by Clark. It goes out. Marenzi, tough shot. Clark, he did that in football. He was an outstanding football player this past year. He went back and picked off that pass nicely. And now, James picks off the pass. And laying it in is Galeano Flores. Under a minute left. St. Mary's is not going to get their 100 points, but they're going to get their 24th win. Off the rim, no good. The ball goes to the floor. They finally call a jump ball. It'll be Chelsea's basketball. Battling on the floor, Jonathan Alvarez. This should be Chelsea's last trip down court. They throw it away. Yeah. St. Mary's, they opened up a 5-0 lead. It went downhill from that for Chelsea. A 16-5 run got it up to 22. They come out, outscored Chelsea 27-15 in the third period. They got it up well over 30 points. It ends up 34. St. Mary's wins it 94-60 over Chelsea. For Chelsea, Bonito had 18. Vasquez had 14, 4 3-point baskets. And Baptista had 10 for St. Mary's. Merriman had 12. Galanges had 8. Marenzi had 2. Ryan Freer had 2. Maraca had 7. Allie Barry had 23. And David Barry had 40 for the Spartans as they pick up their 24th win of the season. They'll be back here at home. They'll take on either familiar foe Austin Prep or Norwell, who are playing right now. And St. Mary's will move now into the Sweet 16, finishing up right now at 24-1. Chelsea will finish up with their Greater Boston League. They finish up 11-11 as exactly 500. So we hope you enjoyed it. 94-60, St. Mary's over Chelsea. I'm John Hoffman saying we'll see you next time.